Welcome to Route 66, a story of a hillbilly diplomacy, a documentary exploring the significant history of the Mother Road and the trials and tribulations throughout.
Route 66 was essential to the growth of the communities it touched, bridging divides between people both literally and figuratively, opening up opportunities for diplomacy to shine. Therefore, we feel it is important to tell the story of Route 66 in our local community to show how it has affected and still affects us today.
So this route's been used by man and animal for many thousands of years.
Well before Route 66 became the famous highway, this was the easiest, most accessible path through the rugged Ozarks. Even prehistoric animals such as mastodon and later bison are thought to have forged this trail. This route was also later part of the Trail of Tears, uses the old wire road to send telegraphs during the Civil War, finally becoming Missouri Highway 17.
This is Route 66 in 1926, on its way through Hooker.
In the first decade of the 20th century, transportation in Pulaski County was still by horseback and rail. In 1909, the first automobile drove into the heart of the Ozarks, and by 1914, automobiles were becoming common in this area. By the mid-1920s, America needed to reorganize the jumble of trails into a system of numbered highways crossing the whole continent.
They sat down with a bunch of maps, and they fashioned Route 66, connecting existing roads.
The Federal Bureau of Public Roads formed a committee of five to organize these roads and name the route from Chicago to LA Route 60. Much debate ensued, with officials from Kentucky strongly objecting to the numbering and claiming number 60 for themselves. The debate went on for many months across numerous federal agencies and involving many states. In what would become a world-changing and nation-shaping argument held by letter and telegraph, B.H. Pietmeyer, chief engineer of the Missouri State Highway Department, and Cyrus Stevens Avery, Oklahoma Highway Commissioner and the father of Route 66, fought bitterly against the change of the highway, running from Chicago to LA being changed from 60 to 62, but Kentucky officials wouldn't back down.
Get your kicks on Route 66.
Left with few popular numbers to choose from, a great compromise was met, and the catchy number 66 was assigned to what quickly became the most famous highway in American history, affectionately known as the Main Street of America.
Here in Pulaski County, small towns like Devil's Elbow, Hooker, and Waynesville already existed before Route 66. The road improvements and the promise of tourists brought mom-and-pop businesses to set up along Route 66 and flourish.
Hooker, known as Basketville by tourists, was one of the small towns that thrived in the early days of Route 66. By the 1930s, the short stretch of Route 66 that comes through Hooker had about 20 mom-and-pop shops along the original road.
Entrepreneurial Ozarkers were drawn to the business opportunities Route 66 brought their region, and many moved closer to the road and started their businesses. Here in Pulaski County, a predominantly rural area, locals were stereotypically hillbillies, which was mostly derogatory. However, with the new businesses, hillbilly was being embraced and became a common marketing appeal. Here, the hills of white oak lent themselves to the creation of beautiful baskets with the abundant nearby materials. These skilled craftsmen also saw opportunity and the uniqueness of their old-fashioned ways and worked to embrace the hillbilly name and image. Tourists from more urban areas were enamored with the beautiful handicrafts and the charming craftsmen and women, helping to break down the stigmas of the Ozarks and bridge the divide of Missouri's urban and rural areas. This is just one example of how Route 66 brought different people together from east to west, truly becoming the Main Street of America, a diplomat in and of itself.
A gentleman down in Kabul, he was a basket maker. He'd heard about this new federal road up north. So he loaded his family, covered wagon, and came north because he'd heard that, you know, there were going to be a lot of tourists on this new federal road. He built his workshop, and he built a log cabin. And it's hard for you to see, but it says made by Ozark Hillbillies.
Well, we're at the site of the original Munger Moss sandwich shop that was built in the early 30s by and operated by Nell Munger and Howard Moss. And Howard was famous for his Kentucky P pit barbecue, and people came from miles around. It was also certainly a favorite with patrons from Fort Leonard Wood, beginning in 1941 with its construction.
In the 1940s, during World War II, Fort Leonard Wood was constructed just south of Route 66 in Pulaski County. The increase in traffic led to traffic jams on Route 66, and the military also needed a better route for their large vehicles. Therefore, it was imperative that an improved section be built, resulting in the famous Hooker Cut.
This is Hooker Cut behind me. This is the first four lane on Route 66 that was constructed and opened. And by the way, it was also the last stretch of four lane to be used too, as they were building I-44.
However, these early improvements were the first in a long series of rerouting and bypassing that resulted in entire communities dissolving into non-existence. All of Hooker and Devil's Elbow were bypassed by the improved four lane, causing many local establishments to close or relocate, thus beginning a series of debates and difficult choices where we still only see a shell of Route 66 in its former glory.
With the construction of the four lane, which is just back up the road a mile, Devil's Elbow, like Hooker, was bypassed. The Munger Moss wasn't the gold mine that it had been in the past, so Howard and Nell Moss sold it, and they wound up moving to Rolla, and the new owners kept it for a while, but the bypass was really hurting business, and they sold it, and they moved to Lebanon, establishing another Munger Moss business. They took the name with them, in other words. The old Munger Moss then became known, particularly beginning in the 60s, as the Elbow Inn, as it is known today.
Here you can see the original narrow 1928 route, as well as the improved four-lane stretch completed after World War II. These two businesses illustrate the change in orientation well, as Sunset Rest, once a filling station and a bus stop, faced the original route, whereas Dale's Sporting Goods faced the improved four-lane.
In fact, before the construction of the new road leading to Hooker Cut, Sunset Rest had also a semicircle of log tourist cabins typical for the era. There was a great debate, but the state condemned part of their land for the four-lane pavement, and the cabins were destroyed.
Devil's Elbow once had a Conoco filling station, restaurant, a hardware store, and a two-story hotel, and was designated one of the seven most scenic places in the state. And here at the top of Devil's Elbow Hill, in an area known as Grandview, the original route dead ends into what completely replaced Route 66, I-44. Here you can see both the original two-lane and the improved four-lane still in use as a local road known today as Highway Z.
In 1985, Route 66 was officially decommissioned and replaced by Interstate 44, a modern highway with on-ramps and exits and no roadside businesses in the historical sense. This was the end of Route 66 as the mother road of America.
But the legacy of Route 66 endures in the ways that it shaped America. Tourists from across the globe still come to drive the whole route and enjoy the nostalgic attractions that have been maintained, as well as the relics of days gone by. Route 66 through the Ozarks serves as an example of the ways America bridged the urban and rural divide. In this, the very existence of the road itself is an example of diplomacy and the subtle way of bringing together people and communities from not just the Ozarks and cities, or even America, but the whole world.
We dedicate this documentary in honor of the priceless spaces that are now lost beneath the pavement.